Hello everyone and welcome to Vainglory Seed Micro Tournament Spring Season 2016 presented to you by Dash Motion Join Gain Experience Improve. Hello, welcome to the finals! Yep. If your friends are not here yet, please invite them because we will be having an ice giveaway later on because that is our tradition that we give out ice during the finals. Yeah. So let me put the other two caster on. Today we have, I think it's Ferdy and MKC000. Hello,
I'm Ferdy. Hi.
Hello, guys. I'm MKC000.
This competition is actually recognized by SEMC, just not their official tournament. You would have known that their official tournament is VIPL and stuff like that. We are not the official one, but they do still sponsor us.
So, anyway, yeah. You actually know that Supersonic Sky is just released, right?
Yep, and we're already seeing...
We have a tier 2 Supersonic Sky here.
Oh, let's have a close up on that. Oh, I didn't on the zoom thingy.
You guys just have to zoom in from your own, you know, whatever browser.
Yeah, this is the Supersonic Sky. We see Rose Remix playing on that Supersonic Sky. What do y'all think about the new update, guys?
Okay, I think this update, a lot of people say Alpha is actually very strong. Mm-hmm. And then there are a lot of new cool skins, so especially with all the chests, right? I got so much ice, I'm so happy for the update. This is like the happiest update for me for these few patches.
Yeah, this is basically the giveaway, the players update, where it actually rewards those players that are, you know, with them for the longest, actually.
Yeah,
something
but
like that.
But the thing is, right, the cards are very, very random. So I have people telling me that, after opening all their cards all the way up to level 20 or something like that, they got like 30k ice. 30k glory. 30k glory and almost 1k ice. And then I'm like, okay, I only have like 900 ice. And then like very little glory. I feel very bad. Because I get lesser.
I only got like 700 ice from the...
Yeah, I got less than that. Never mind.
Yeah, so that's why it's like a bit sad. But the thing is, just now I accidentally signed out from my account by mistake, and then I realized that the initiation process now is so much nicer, and they are actually giving out the scarf tier 2, tier 1 skin for anybody that signs up immediately.
Anyway,
isn't that cool?
They're
giving out skins to new people.
Nice one from Team A, actually. Once Taka used the Kaku, they actually dropped the scout trap, so they can actually see exactly where Taka is.
Yeah, I just think that this new update is really nice. Really cool of them to give us a lot of things. Yeah, we see a fight in the lane. Going for Black Feather, but Black Feather managed to run off. Current score right now is 0-0. We have just started. This is the first game. KD is 3-1. We see that stun right there. Will Catherine be able to take down Black Feather? No! Last hit on that Black Feather, not able to grab, but Catherine also survives with her last hit.
However, in the jungle, there was actually a fight going on with Sky taking down Fortress.
Oh, Taka. Go back for the kill.
Anyway, Fortress Taka is supposed to be kind of like a Sky... what's that called?
Ooh,
Sky...
and there goes that Taka.
Sky counter, but the thing here is... nope, there's no countering on Sky. Rose Remix is playing Sky too well, basically.
Yep, it's a very skilled Sky here. And we see the tier 2 skin being used. That's so cool, right? The black color. Guy, I just got a skin too. Still very excited. Haven't got a chance to use it.
Wait, what? You got tier 2 skin already?
Yep.
So you basically paid for tier 1 and you bought the cards for tier 2?
No. I actually saved the Night Shadow Taka cards from last time. So I just destroyed them and then got my tier 2 straight.
Whoa.
I was waiting for this day.
Oh my god. But you main Sky, right?
Yeah, you can say that. I play Sky quite a lot nowadays.
Okay, that's good. Anyway, they're going up on Sky, but seems like
The team has just give up busting Frosty Wolf decide to go in and died there. Why am I talking about all the other IGN but not the correct IGN? Yeah, Frosty Wolf.
That might be a miscommunication there. Frosty Wolf might have thought that, you know, his team was going in, but then
his
team was actually kicking out.
If you are wondering about the skill tier, I think Stingray is like the hotness or something, right?
Stingray is in...
I cannot remember their skill
tier. SA Go now.
SA
Go now.
Okay. And the other side is Vainglorious. Hi, Mango! Hello. Speaking of destroying cards, what do you think about the Rona Bunny cards that is only destroyed for like 10 essence?
I feel so sad because like I got 18 cards just before the update. I was like 2 cards away, but I just have to destroy all of them.
But one card is like 10 essence. I feel like we should wait out. Maybe the essence will increase. I have 15 cards
the essence
and
I haven't
sold it yet.
The essence won't increase, but the thing is, because it's limited edition, there's a chance they'll bring it back once in a while, probably in a year plus, something like that. If you save it till then, probably it's more worth than you destroying it, like, you know, now for 10 essence. That's what I think.
Mm.
I believe it will be back, but when? No idea.
Well, I was a bit, I just destroyed it all.
I don't know what to do with them because like 10 essence is like super low and then I have like 5 cards left, so I don't know what to do with it.
Anyway, at this moment from the game you can see that Remix is really you know, doing a lot better than Glacius.
Mm-hmm.
This is KD of 6-1 and a goal lead of about 2.5k.
Mm-hmm. Yep, Sky is so daring, keeps wanting to go for an invade.
Yo, that was close. They almost got Black Feather though.
Although the thing is, right, you can clearly see that Team B, they have more vision. Their vision is really good, as in the amount of scout threats that they have and everything is really good. But
yeah, they constantly
seem to be not using that to their advantage.
No, they're unable to actually. The invades are far too often, far too quick, so there's no way they can do anything.
Yep. Putting the sculpture at the tri-bar is actually a very good choice, but then because they keep invading, the sculpture just get popped again and again.
And as we say that, Catherine just popped another sculpture.
I would say Skull Trap is important, but buying too much of it is actually not a very good strategy too, because Skull Trap actually costs quite a bit.
Yeah, it will harm your build, right?
Yeah, looking at it, like 8 minutes and Fortress actually haven't got a fountain yet, so that's Skull Traps definitely play a big part in that too.
Mm-hmm. You see that because of that no fountain thing, his team just died off there. Team A is now going for the turret, first turret. Ooh, not able to get that turret. 1/4 left. Gold mine is full at this moment, but none of them is going down for the gold mine. Stingray, are you sure? Sky is right there.
Sky, he doesn't know Sky is there though. Oh, stolen.
Come on, 3v1, you can take down this guy, go! Yeah.
There you go.
But Fortress is low in health though.
Guy went a little bit. He will heal because of the what's that called? The over there.
Contract.
Contract. No.
Contract. Yes. But at the same time, there's a life spring. Contract got heal. Oh yeah, got heal. Wait, no. Contract doesn't have a.
It will give you the. It will give you health back when your ally.
Yep, but it's not fast enough. But yeah, this life spring does give health.
Oh, and we see a comeback right here. Taka and Black Panther just took down Catherine and Glaive, making the KD to 9-5. Sky is coming up, rotating up right there. So Black Panther should be going for the Black Panther right now. 2v1 with that Black Panther low in health. I don't think they can do much to that Sky. One last
Taka's
hit on this guy,
trying.
Come on! Ooh, Taka!
Yes, Taka is trying.
Taka is good. Hashtag Taika bias. Catherine and Glaive is constantly working together, like walking everywhere together. So
yeah,
they
I would say I would say Sky is actually quite fat now in the jungle, so they are they have like Sky is actually quite confident now going for like most of the 3v1 or like 2v1 situations, and that's what actually making them, you know, suffer a little bit from that.
Team B is regrouping into the jungle. Are they gonna attack?
It's interesting that the way Catherine played was in the early part of the game, he keep popping scout traps as much as possible,
mm-hmm.
till Team B's kind of, you know, start to give up on placing scout trap at all.
Ooh,
and
Taka
then
dangerous. Taka dangerous. Taka got
and
stuck.
Then in the late game, he just put as many scout traps as he can. Now.
Yeah, that fountain was a little too late, going for the Sky right now. Black Feather. Black Feather is going down. Yep, Black Feather just went down. Stingray is kinda safe. Got stunned by Catherine and should go down, but yep, taken down by. Oh, last hit by Catherine. I thought it was the Sky, but no, it was Catherine.
Anyway, yeah, the thing is, the Taka actually used the A ability too soon just now. He was trying to go for the Sky, but he instead of going to the back of the Sky, he actually hopped to the front of the Sky, which caused him to be killed by the follow barrage.
Yeah, follow barrage is. Gold mine was taken by Team A, 300 gold payout, and we see Black Feather in lane alone. Risky time to be alone, especially where they know that Glaive is constantly walking around with Catherine. That stun and that, what do you call that? His ability of throwing.
Which one?
Glaive.
The afterburn?
Yeah,
yes, it's called afterburn, yes, correct.
Yeah, the afterburn.
Which means I'm correct. I was like, afterburn? Then I'm like doubting myself. Is it called afterburn? Yeah, it's afterburn.
Yeah, so basically, Catherine and then the stun and then the afterburn is. Really painful, so they should be careful of that duo there.
Oh, and there goes Taka again. Black Feather is left. Black Feather is gonna try, really? Nope, he's not gonna get it.
I would have run
bubble.
In that situation, but okay.
Yeah, the bubble was up there on Catherine, so it's definitely not a good time to try.
Yeah, with that stun and the afterburn is like super good. Especially if they combo it, it'll be like super nice. A lot of people hate Taka. What's with the hate on Taka? So sad. Don't hate Taka.
Because Taka is too sneaky. If you play Taka well, your Taka will be very sneaky and you should be able to kill quite a lot of people.
Grabbing that Catherine right there. Finish that Catherine first. Yes, okay, good job. Now go for the Glaive.
I'm not sure if that Catherine was actually aware that, you know.
Yeah, I think the Catherine was just shopping and then didn't realize.
It's either shopping or disconnected because he totally didn't realize.
Mm-hmm.
He totally didn't move. Totally did not at all.
Okay, we see Black Feather and Taka going for the turret, while Fortress is trying to take down the gold mine himself. You think Fortress can do that? I don't think so, right?
No. Currently, it would be good if he has a Storm Guard. Maybe talking about Taka, right? Taka is actually quite a strong hero, especially if you know how to use. Because of the first skill, the dodge is actually very good for, you know, dodging stuns and even the burst damages. So if you know how to use it well, you can just win the game really easily.
Yeah, but there's a lot of hate on Taka though. Like, there is a few streams that I've been on, like other people streaming, and then I go over and I ask them, hey, what do you think about Taka? And then they'll be like, hate Taka! Current KD is 16 to 10, goal difference of 2k. Both first turret is down, but. Okay. Team B is left with 3 turret.
Yeah, we have infusions bought, some infusions bought on both teams. I would say, Glacius is actually catching up slowly, and Black Feather is stronger in the late game too, so we'll see how it works out. They're taking the Kraken now.
Yep. Speaking of infusions, you can only infuse once this time.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I really still can't get used to that.
Yeah. The chasing, after getting the Kraken, weakening the whole team, so Glacius is most likely going down with Taka down now, and one guy left stunned, not able to move at all, and
this is a really bad time to ace with that Kraken and the whole team going in.
Yeah, ace with a Kraken pushing.
Yeah, and that 30 seconds cooldown. Is it cooldown? No, respawn time. Yeah.
It's really cool because Catherine did was once the Kraken is activated, she straight away warhorn all the way towards the enemy because she saw the scout trap there, I think, or something. She basically saw the enemy there, and she just used the warhorn and just dash all the way towards them, and the whole team did not even expected it. None of Glacius actually expected that, and it's like suddenly they just have to turn around. Nobody has the warhorn. Everybody, I think, they use the boots towards the Kraken instead of away from the Kraken, so they can't run at all, and that's where they die.
Yeah, that was a really good decision made by Catherine though.
I thought
there would be a chance for Glacius to come back, but just because of one mistake, the game.
Yep, so these are the items. I am not sure if they sold their items. I don't think so. But yeah, okay. Let's go for the second round.
Yep, there's a saw there. We're seeing a very traditional push com.
Yep, this is a traditional push com. It's really not used as much now. No, it's not used as much nowadays, from what I know, because push com is hard to play. You have to be at the lane. Most of your heroes have to be in the lane most of the time to push in the early part of the game before Saw stagnate in the late game or something like that. So you have to be always pushing in the early part of the game. Your level will be lower, but because you are one comm that is very good at pushing, you usually can do quite well if you stick to the plan.
Yeah, you said that the push comm needs to stay in lane, right? But there is a crew, so having a crew means that you have to invade their jungle a lot so that to make sure that the crew don't
That's the thing. So basically, having a push comm, right, you need to balance pushing in lane and invading the jungle, which is a lot of people cannot do it properly. They will either mess up and basically mess up both, or they will mess up one and they will end up being able to push like you know, the first three turrets and then they just stagnate there and they just lose the whole game after
yeah,
that.
Yeah, wait until like late game. Then they try
Basically the situation now is we have a turret destroyed at 1 minute. So why is this so? It's because firstly, the blue team actually went for a reverse rotation. That means they start from the front camps first. And why I think they want to do that is because they know crew is a weak early game. They don't want to fight against Adagio. So they want to go reverse rotate and then rotate up to the lane to go for a gank on Saw. But the sad thing is Saw is poking Black Feather so much he had to recall, and the clearing speed for crew is not fast. So all three members of Remix actually went up to lane and get the first turret in 1 minute 30 seconds.
Yep. So this team actually able to play the pushcom really well, because I can say that pushcom is really not easy to play.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of people who selected this combination, which is the Arden Adagio and Saw. This combination, and then they play the normal way where it's the jungle Arden. Jungle Adagio. Yeah, and then it's really annoying because I will like try to push, and then they'll be like, no, don't push, don't push. I'm like, what's the point of you selecting this combo if you are not going to push?
Yep.
Look at it, the second terror is taken at 2 minutes.
Yep, we can see that Arden might be going down. Yep, Arden did go down. Now it's a 3v1 with the Adagio. Adagio with his heal and his buff can be quite painful at times.
Black Feather is deciding not to help at all instead of trying to bait Ibsen to attack him so that his team has a chance and something like that. Basically, he's not doing anything. He's just farming while his team is getting trashed.
Oh, this is a bad timing to come and invade the forest after that fight with the Adagio. Both, most of their teammates are like low in health. So they tried to invade the jungle and that was a bad timing. Crew just went down right there.
All I can say is at the moment, crew should focus on just leveling as much as possible. Prepare for the late game. In fact, Black Feather is also quite a late game hero. That's why. So in a way, this is a late game comp with same thing. You have Fortress here, which is also a late game hero. So basically, as long as they can drag the whole game to the time of Kraken without Remix being able to push too much, which I think I'm too late in saying this. Then they most likely can turn things around. But at the moment, it doesn't seem like it because it's basically not looking good. In fact, if you notice, Ibsen is not playing Crystal Adagio here.
Oh, Weapon Adagio!
As in, he haven't bought a Crystal.
Yeah, he's just basically picking up the attack speed.
Yeah, the speed.
So he can push the turret faster. And Remix know that they are, you know, late game heroes, so they want to push as much as they can. They want to end this game really, really soon.
I mean, if it's the case where it's like the normal push com hero where they push all the way to third turret and then couldn't go in, and then all the other team has, the team A has to do is to drag to late game. Right? That would work, right?
Yes, kind of.
I'm not being glorious, don't tell people I'm being glorious.
Then Glorian player, that's the difference.
No, I was joking about the vainglorious thing because you know how most vainglorious teams, how they play is that they will end the game in 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
So I went into like a bot fight and then I was like super bot, and then I end the game in like less than 5 minutes or something like that. And then I'm like, oh, look at me, I'm vainglorious, I can play the game in 10 minutes. Yeah, jokingly lah, but still. Anyway, crew just went down, fortress just went down. It looks like Saw wasn't able to tank there. He just went out killed by Black Feather, and Arden managed to pick up the Black Feather in return. So that's the ace going for both turret at the same time. Crew is out. Crew is trying to do a lot of damage to Adagio, trying his best. I think Adagio should go down right there. Yep, nice kill from Crew. Arden is now trying to run using his max boots. Come on, come on. Come on, run, run! I don't think that ability will help you though. Running straight into Saw though. Arden goes down. Saw is right there. Saw is a slow hero, so with their combination, they should be able to do something.
No, the thing is they are taking turns to go in. They have to go in together. But anyway, you realize that the Arden is playing some special famous person's build. Attempting to. No fountain and tier 3 boots. Sounds familiar, guys? This is so annoying because I think there are a lot of people that are trying this build, even though I've like played it like half a year
ago. Did it work for you?
Half a year ago? Yeah, it definitely works half a year ago.
But now not so sure.
Now, hey, come on, I was playing that on your stream just now.
Oh yeah, I didn't notice.
Yeah, but
current KD is
9-9. End up had fountain.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah, just that I bought the fountain like mid game.
Nice stun from that crew, no follow up right there. That will be the bad move from his team. Yep, we can see that his team is going down. Definitely going down because there was no follow up and then others gauntlet went in, so definitely should go down.
Yep, they just want to push. They just want to push and
they are pushing.
Probably the game.
They are pushing and pushing and pushing and they should be winning. Come on! Ooh, nice kill! Come on, another kill. They're taking turns to kill. Come on.
And there you go.
8 minute game.
Yep, 8 minute game. This is definitely the
standard of being glorious.
Yep, standard of being glorious team. So, alright, the second question. Oh my god, I just did something stupid.
No, the thing is, it's interesting how now their KD is 10-13. That's what I wanted to say because just now their KD was really far away, so now it's 10-13, so it's not that bad. It feels like they are trying really hard to push back the Bing Glorious team. So maybe we'll see a Dajo ban later.
Okay, let me ask this question then. I'll type it up.
Okay, ice giveaway, hold on.
Okay, let me type it out. You guys can talk while I type.
Yeah. Okay, Rose Remix just went out. Aqua is still here. Ipsum is still here. Aqua just left. I think he's trying to see who is gonna play later in the third.
We on a slow mode or something?
Not yet.
Not yet. I don't think he asked the question yet. No.
No, not yet. Not yet.
Yeah, this is a best of 5 and we allow them to sell the items because we just allow them to sell the items. There is no rule that is stated in our tournament that you cannot sell items, so just go ahead, sell your item if you feel that it is necessary. So yeah, questions should be coming out soon. Do you all notice the build? Stingray, please play properly. Come on. Not because of homework run away, okay? I feel like I'm a bad parent or something. Okay, anyway. Where's the other player? Wait.
This question will be very hard. I have to tell you guys. It's quite hard. Unless you guys really notice exactly what build they have for every team member.
Okay. Go!
And the question is here.
Wait, I don't see the question. Okay. Slow mode activated. For the second set of ice, what are all the tier 3 items that Glacier's board at the end of the game. Hint, there is only 3 items. Good luck. I don't know.
You cannot have only one answer, never mind. We have one person that got it correct already. But I prefer the second person who answer it because it's a full answer.
Yeah, we'll take the full answer.
The full answer, the person who get the full answer is Legacy.
Legacy 420, say ice me.
The answer is 2 Shiver Steel and 1 Fountain. And Keith was very close, but it's not a full answer.
Aww.
So Legacy will win this.
Aww. Aww, really so sad.
Math also got it.
he was just a little
Math
too lazy, dead. But okay. Yeah, I
Math
see.
Is dead.
Huh?
Math is third, but it's also not full because it's not Fountain of Renewal. It's found as in he didn't type Fountain of Renewal, it's Fountain, which is wrong. Legacy is correct.
Yay, Legacy! Okay, please send us your screenshot of your Mob Crush profile and your in-game profile to our Facebook page, facebook.com/VGSeed. Somebody please type that. Mob Crush profile and... No, not that one, the other one! Mob Crush profile and in-game profile. Wait, did I switch them? No, I didn't. This one goes down, this one go here, and this one go here. Oh. What happened?
Sorry, my headphones is out of battery.
No, this is our third game. It is a best of 5, so hold on. And in-game profile. Profile. How can I spell profile wrong? Okay, we will start now. The team is ready. So. Are you guys ready?
Yeah, just go.
Yep, let's go.
The draft begins. Alpha Ben. The blue team is Remix and the red team is Glacius. You did not miss all the games. This is the third game. Both the first and second game goes to Remix, so this is the best of 5. So
okay.
This is the third game. Yeah.
Can I say this? For the third set of eyes, please watch out for this screen. This current screen.
Oh, this screen.
Oh, this screen.
Focus on this screen. See what they choose, what they didn't choose, and stuff like that. What was the hero that they selected, they pre-selected, and stuff like that. Yeah, focus on this screen. Thank you so much, Rock! So we have Adagio and Black Feather separated. Wait, are they going... Oh. Yep, they're going for the push comb once again.
Yep, I will go for a early burst hero now if I'm on the team of Glacius. You know, I don't want to let them just push.
Oop, so we have a sky here. A scarf here. Scarf.
Scarf.
Scarf is also a late game hero. Sort of.
Yeah, Scarf is now considered a newbie hero.
Newbie hero?
Yeah, when you first get into Vainglory, you download the app, and then there is this initiation page, right? You get to play Taka, Ringo, and Scarf, and then as you play Scarf, the last, I think it's the last mission that you have, which is to kill the Vayne Crystal. after that, right, they will give you a free, so-called free, like, scarf skin, which is, like, quite cool. So, yeah. They are teaching newbies how to play scarf.
Nowadays, like, after this update, people tell me, you know, they play weapon scarf. I'm wondering how they build it.
Weapon scarf?
Don't know. Yeah, have you guys heard of weapon scarf this update just yesterday?
Probably it's people using the calculation behind calculating all the items, the builds and the base damage and everything to see if scarf is weapon scarf is viable, and I think they kind of did it, so we shall see. Definitely someday, sometime before the next update, you will see more and more weapon scarf and streams on weapons scarf, and even YouTube videos of weapon scarf around. So we'll see by then.
Maybe you guys can do it on your stream.
No,
I'll watch it.
No, we no.
I don't play scarf, so yeah. Actually, I'm trying to train a laner. But anyway, Black Feather is going for the Arden. Going really, really head to head for the Arden.
Whoa.
Arden does go down, but Adagio managed to pick him, pick Black Feather up. We see Remix trying to corner that Catherine right there.
That was really close.
I would say the Catherine didn't want to fight there, but the Black Feather went on because he sees a chance of Arden. Adagio early game is really strong in the jungle. Most Adagio will invade.
It's interesting that this scarf is not really doing well at the moment. If I were the scarf, I would have bought a battery if I know I'm going against a saw. Yes, because going against a saw, the chances of you really wanting to do damage is not very high. Like, the amount of damage, look at it, he's not doing enough damage because Saw has the Book of Eulogy, so he's like constantly healing by himself.
But if it's with a battery, he could just use his ability again and again.
Yep.
Then just like keep burning that Saw.
That's where you can really prevent the Saw from getting near you, because half the time you see Scarf has not enough energy to carry on.
Yeah, like now currently his energy bar is low. Catherine is still going for the stun.
I think Catherine is just trying to get the stacks, the hero perk for the weapons.
But it looks weird just now because Catherine just stunned and then Catherine left and then Scarf went in for the ability, which was like really weird. Scarf tried to teleport right there but not able to. Got stopped by Arden. All of Team A is now in the lane, but Black Feather is still not rotating up.
Right.
Catching Scarf is still alive, but low in energy as usual, and so they can.
Wrong place to come up.
I can only say that Scarf is not able to sustain, and so they lose the turret. He have to find a way to sustain. As much as possible, as long as possible, so that you know, Saw don't have the chance to push the turret.
Yeah, we see them pushing the second turret right now in 3 minutes. Black Feather is trying to take out that Adagio. I think he will be. Yep.
Oh, and the Saw is down. Nice one.
Yeah, good one. Good. Okay.
But turret
Arden
is down.
Left. Turret is down though.
Yep, two turrets down. In 3.5 minutes.
Yeah, 3.5 minutes. It's funny how they were asking me about the lag issue where, you know, we have this rule, if you surrender before 5 minutes and show us a screenshot of your pings, we will restart the game for you. Mm-hmm. And Remix was actually asking about that, but they are doing so well, I don't think they need the handicap now.
They're actually just, I think it's just better that they give the handicap to the next team.
Because Ipsum was actually lagging a lot in his previous game.
Yep.
And he didn't know that there is this thing where you can surrender, if you surrender under 5 minutes, you can like restart the game. He waited all the way until like 30 minutes and then he surrendered.
What?
Yeah, hello?
I'm just thinking about how to counter this saw push com, and I think the most important thing is to have really fast jungle rotations, go up to the lane as often as you can.
Yeah, but the way that they are rotating is so splitted that the team is taking them down one by one.
Yep, Scarf is busy healing in base, and that's another turret for them.
Yep, third turret is destroyed in 5 minutes. This game should end within 10 minutes. Sad to say.
One more game within 10 minutes. It's 5 minutes only, though. No.
I think under 10 minutes. They should end the
That's
game
right.
under 10 minutes.
That's why I said, this is, at this moment, it's just 5 minutes.
Yeah.
It's really, really quick.
Okay, I think you can finish that. Yep, good job there, Frost. Picking up Adagio. Still trying to poke at Aqua. I think he will be able to get it. But after that, he should return back to base or something, because Saw and Adagio is out. He shouldn't wander around alone.
At the moment, I would say that because Saw is not as fast, he could have just farmed.
Saw is not that fast. Saw just flew all the way halfway through the map to grab that black.
But the thing is, there's only two of them, and to me, it's better that you farm. As long as you know that there's no vision around. Not sure if there's vision around, but there's no vision around, so you can actually just invade, get their jungle, get your own jungle, and go back to base.
Yep, Team B is regrouping in base. Hopefully they will not be separated. No, Blackfeather, join your team! Fight! Come on!
Actually, if I was playing this and I'm the jungler, I'll basically go for the minion mines as much as possible. Make it harder for the push comp to push. Just go straight for minion mines for farm. My laner will just have to defend as much as possible. Not push at all and play extremely safe, hugging the turret the whole time. Until the minion mines are both taken and stuff like that, and that's where the whole team will push against the push comp. It's you can't play it the normal way where you rotate and rotate. I don't think the rotation actually works fast enough, well enough in this case, because I can say that Team A's, the remix team, their push comp is just too fast.
They're playing the push comp really well, and then this Arden again does not go for the traditional build. We have the tier 3 boots.
The tier 3 boots again, and the swift shooter basically. It's like tier 3 boots, Warhorn, and then go for the salvo, and the last item is one of the attack speed. But the thing is,
tornado trigger.
In the end, they will still get the fountain. It's just that it's like the fourth or third item. Just like tissue boots, and then.
Official, don't anyhow mute people, or else I take away your privilege.
Official cannot participate in giveaways. Official is too rich. He don't need the giveaway.
No, Official is a mod. He cannot take the
Not
ice.
Exactly. He's not exactly a mod. Not officially a mod. He's just a guest mod, something like that. So, but the thing here is, he's too rich. He don't need the giveaways. Oh, and nice one. They took down Dagio, so the buff comp is no longer buffy.
Actually, I would like to point out, just now Katarina actually stole the gold mine while Saul was just casually doing it. That was
I actually noticed that the using the silence to steal the gold mine actually.
Wow, pro gamer, you still remember? Okay. The thing about my eyes is that it's harder to win, Ferdy is just asking random questions and stuff like that so that you can win ice. For me, you have to get this view up to 600 views, okay? You have to get this video up to 600 views, then I'll give out the ice. 600 views. It's quite easy if it's a best of 5, usually. But yeah, grab your friends here so that we can hit 600 views so that you get ice. Or rather, you stand a chance to get ice.
Yep, now we are at 449. Newest update.
600 views, okay? Come on.
I realized that I'm no more a mod.
What? You're not a mod? Okay, I mod you. Wait, don't move. Let me mod you. Can I mod you? Appoint as mod. Okay. Use your power wisely. Go for the Adagio, you can do it! Yeah, and the Adagio is dead. Scarf is now using his ulti, trying to grab remix whatever they can grab. Arden? Arden is there. Black Feather is still going back with the poking. They have been poking all 10 minutes. That's also wrong. And there you go, that's the ace.
Anyway, back to the game. I've been noticing Remix trying very hard to push into the base, pushing, want to end the game early. And Glacius is doing a good job by just staying there, protecting. And
you can see the KD is 12-6.
Yeah, they're just basically defending very well, killing them.
Yeah, but that Scarf is like totally out of place with nobody to help him. Okay, he managed to get away safely. That's good.
But I can only say that this is the main tactic to go against a buff comp. You have to go slow. You have to go with defensive until the late game where all your heroes are, you know, especially your late game hero like Scarf, like Black Feather, and basically these two heroes get to the peak, and when Saw is at the bottleneck, that's where the best time to actually counter. But at the moment, they still have to play defensive.
Yep, really Patrick defensive. Just went down right there. He was like trying to protect Scarf, but okay, Scarf is alive, but Catching went down.
One turret left, so they have to. Oh,
the ulti once again, Isom just went down. Rose, come on, Rose! Rose Whoa. Just went down, even with that reflex block, he wasn't able to survive. Back to the poking.
And so the thing here is they got all the turrets down. This is gonna be a final push here. They Glaciers have to be there to be playing defensive, or they could actually just do something about this, farm or go forward or something like that. They are basically not. They're trying to push, but not good enough.
It's either you kill all of them and win, or you die.
I would say Glaciers is doing a good job. They maintain the goal lead, the goal difference for now. And if they can just hold a little bit longer, you know, to the 18th minute, they might actually have a better chance of winning every team fight from there.
Yeah, that's the thing. That's why they have to drag the game for some, like, yeah.
They only have a crystal left, so...
Yes, that's the thing, but they only have a crystal left, so it's very, very hard now. It's just a final push from Remix. One final push, and the stun. Gauntlet is used, the stun there, trying to use the ulti, and... Scarf
nice,
is down.
Nice.
Adagio is down.
Continue,
trying
continue,
to go
don't
for
give up.
Saw. They're definitely going for Saw first, because Saw is gonna do the most damage, and yes, that's they go.
Yeah, and that's the end of that game. Apparently,
this is the third win, right?
Yeah, this is the third win, and apparently Sword tried to double infuse right there.
Hey, it's always like that. You can't get used to it.
Yeah, double infuse doesn't work anymore, guys. Please read the updates. It doesn't work.
Yep. So basically, I think he panicked. He's trying to get out of the base as fast as possible to push, and he can't wait to. And so there you go. That's the game.
Yep, these are the items if you're curious. I think most of them sold their items, but yeah, okay, let me put back the banner. Thank you all of you for watching, and thank you all of you for your love and support. While you're here, please follow and like this stream. That will help us a lot. Thank you very much. This is our micro tournament 7. So we have one last tournament. We have one last tournament left in this season, the spring season, because the spring season is ending soon, and then we also have a BOTC coming up. BOTC is also known as the Battle of the Champions. So basically, we have one last tournament left. The registration for that tournament will be 11 a.m. on Saturday.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, which is tomorrow. So, to participate, all you have to do is go to our Facebook page, which is facebook.com/VGC. Like the page.
Get your whole team
to like the page, and then at 11 a.m. we will have a post stating that this is our micro tournament 8, and if you want to sign up, please sign up here. So basically what you do is you post the information of your team. The first 8 team that register gets into our tournament. So it's the first 8 team, and the registration is 11 a.m. on Saturday. The tournament will be from Monday to Thursday. We have 2 games every day, which is one at 8 p.m., one at 9 p.m. One at 8 p.m. and one at 10 p.m. The finals will be at 9 p.m., which is usually on a Thursday. Friday will be reserved for like anything that happens, like for example, an update, like what happens today, where there is an update yesterday, so we have pushed the finals to Friday. So yeah, so you just have to commit for that 1 week, and after that 1 week, you are free to go. It's not like other tournaments where you have to commit a whole month, where they have a 64 team bracket and you have to commit a whole month. Our tournament gets you to commit 1 week, just that 1 week. So if you're free and you think that you're good, just sign up at our Facebook page, facebook.com/VGC, 11 a.m. on Saturday. If you want to watch past YouTube, past seat videos, because there are teams that are reoccurring. Yeah, there are teams that are reoccurring in our micro tournament. So if you want to do your homework, or you want to know like what are the teams that have participated, and you want to see how they play, some teams are really good. Like we have Awakening that was playing with us in our seat 4. We had Love Hurts, we had Suit and Tie, Ardent Allegiance, and stuff like that. So if you want to see how they play and how good they are and stuff like that, you can watch it on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/c/VainGlory Southeast Asia Tournament. If you want to help our tournament, you can donate to our Patreon, patreon.com/VainGlorySeed. And I'll see you on Monday on mockcrush.com/VainGlorySeed. Yep. Thank you all of you for watching.
Yep, thank you. And see you next Monday.
See you guys.
See you guys. Bye-bye.
Like and follow. Bye-bye.
Sounds like black and yellow.
Like and follow. Okay, bye-bye.